in this ArcelorMittal judgment of Honorable Supreme Court, paragraph 73 is taken for discussion. The time limit for completion of the insolvency resolution process is laid down in section 12. A period of 180 days from the date of admission of the application is given by section 12(1). And this is extendable by a maximum period of 90 days. Only if the committee of creditors by vote of 66% extend the said period, and only if the adjudicating authority is satisfied that such process cannot be completed within 180 days. So if you see that section 12(1) and also section 12(2) into consideration, that 12(1) will say that the maximum period within which this entire process of revival, receiving the plan and then seeing the viability, voting on that and seeing all the other conditions satisfied, should be done within 180 days. That is from T0. And IRP period is 30 days, and that is 1 month is gone, and 150 days is for the resolution process. And now the next question arises is, it is extendable by a period of 90 days, that on subject to two conditions. One is the committee of creditors by vote of, earlier it was 75%, now 66%, extend the said period. So they have to pass a resolution and extend it. And only if that is one thing. That means obviously there, it is again a business decision or a commercial decision. And possibly they have to give reasons. Now section 39 has been introduced. So it is better that committee of creditors in their wisdom during that meeting, which is authorizing them to extend, they must give reasons why they want to extend it. And the adjudicating authority must be satisfied. So there is, it's not just a blind thing that 12(1), 12(2) is only once 90 days will be extended, and the adjudicating authority, just like that, it will not see. It has to apply its judicious mind into that, and authority satisfied that such process cannot be completed within, they have to come, adjudicating authority also must come to this conclusion. The authority may then by order extend the duration of such process by a maximum period of 90 days, section 12(2) and 12(3). What is also of importance is the proviso to section 12(3), which states that any extension of period under section 12 cannot be granted more than once. This has to be read with the third proviso to section 34, which states that maximum period of 30 days mentioned in the second proviso is allowable as the only exception to the extension of the aforesaid period not being granted more than once. So there is a code. The Honorable Supreme Court, that 75% is applying by interpreting the code. So the adjudicating authorities, if you see in practically, they have, we have seen situations where adjudicating authority extended CARP by 3 to 4 times. 450 days it has been extended. Now actually this is not, is there in the law. And also here, when you extend that, there should be a valid reason. We could see in a situation, and the liberty issues just now concluded, Bhushan Power and Steel, about 14 months that was litigation was pending, and therefore they allowed that to be excluded from the computation of the period. Then before then, that means when suppose 12(2) takes place and you come before the court, and the litigation comes again and again, nobody will go into litigation. And so the adjudicating authority should apply this very judiciously, because the CIRP process is more focused on time-bound resolution. And if you see this order also, they said it is not possible to consider the plan. We cannot order the adjudicating authority to reconsider the decision, because the 270 days period is over. And so the timing is given as very, very important, time-bound resolution process. What is important to note is that a consequence is provided in the event that the set period ends either without the receipt of a resolution plan or after rejection of a resolution plan under Section 31. This consequence is provided by Section 33, which makes it clear that when either of these two contingencies occur, the corporate debtor is required to be liquidated in the manner laid down in the Chapter 3. Section 12, construed in the light of the object sought to be achieved by the code and in the light of the consequence provided by Section 33, therefore makes it clear that periods previously mentioned are mandatory and cannot be extended. So, the whole issue that is before us to be answered by the Honorable Supreme Court is, the Honorable Supreme Court has proceeded to answer the first question that is raised before them. They are saying that the proviso that is 75% mandatorily required, this is only it is not a mandatory and it is only directory in nature. So, Supreme Court has taken a decision that it is mandatory. So, there you see, the Honorable Supreme Court relied upon the provision, not amended provision, at that point in time when this decision was taken, what was the provision which says is 75% should be found, should be complied with, that section 30 subsection 4, prevailing at that type point in time, they have taken point number one. Point number two, they want to apply only 75, but the challenge to that 34 is not mandatory. It is only discretionary, directionary, like that. It is only a direct may. The word may has been used. Therefore, they took that stand. Now, Supreme Court, having decided to uphold the judgment of NCLAT, is bound to answer this question that it is mandatory. That should be complied with. So, for that purpose, Honorable Supreme Court applied that judgment in the ArcelorMittal, where paragraph 74 is clearly saying that finally, when the due date is coming, either at 180 days, extended by 90 days, and the resolution applicant, the resolution professional receives and it does not receive any resolution application, situation one. Situation two, resolution plan is received, but committee of creditors in their wisdom felt it is not to be approved. That means 75% voting it could not muster. That means the matter is closed. The CIRP process comes to an end. Here the judicial authority has no right of applying discretion. And he is also told what is a judicious mind is to be applied only with respect to section 30, subsection 4, A to F, that's all, nothing more than that. Then, if you see that, they say that in case you don't comply with these two conditions, the two contingencies can happen or cannot happen. If nothing is happening, then you have to go to the other option is to order for liquidation. And it will go to Chapter 3. Section 12, construed in the light of the object sought to be achieved by the court. Section 12 is a time-bound resolution process. And the light of the consequence provided by Section 33, therefore makes it clear that period previously mentioned are mandatory and not to be extended. So, first part is, it's been answered, that is period you cannot extend. They have been starting this only because they want to say that why you are dismissing this petition appeal. They say that already 270 days is gone and now we order that NCLAT to reconsider that, direct that matter to be remitted back to NCLT. Then what is that they can do? They were going to consider that plan afresh. Then where is the CIRP period? It's already gone. And you cannot claim that this period is lost, that period is lost. Because the resolution plan itself came within that timelines. There was no delay. It was rejected within that timelines. So there is no time left for that to consider another new plan, call for it and all. It's not possible to extend that period of time. And therefore, they took that stand that time is a mandatory as per Section 12, and that is what is said. And again, while dealing with the purport of Section 30, 33, 61, in paragraph 676, they have observed